Well, good evening to you all. I hope that you've come to serve God. I do know that we're here together in one mind and one accord. I know without a shadow of a doubt that where the people of God are gathered together, we are here because He is here. And I do know when He is here, things will happen. It don't matter what you're going through. It don't matter what you're facing. There's one thing I found out to be true, is that as long as Jesus Christ is glorified, all the way the Bible says that Christ be lifted up, He's going to draw all men unto Him. And we're living in a day and age where I'm telling you that Jesus Christ is the only way. He is the truth and the life. The Bible says that to be true, and I believe it. It hasn't changed 2,000 years ago. It hasn't changed a month ago. And it hasn't changed today. And I believe that it's not going to change tomorrow. I know it's not going to change a week from now. And I can guarantee you it's not going to change for all of eternity that Jesus Christ is the one. Praise be to the Lord. We have a special treat for you here this evening. Here we are. Praise God. We have a wonderful brother that's been here before, Brother Orlando Perez and his family. And he's going to minister to us here in a little while. But in the meantime, we're going to go ahead and worship God. We're going to go ahead and praise Him and thank Him for His goodness and His grace. And we're going to come together just knowing that He's here, but giving Him the worship He so deserves. So if we could, we're going to go ahead and pray and open up in a few songs and just let the Lord have His way. Dear Father, we love You, we praise You, we thank You, God, for bringing us here together. I'm asking You, my Lord, as we are here in Your name, that You receive this worship. My Lord, that You would receive this love. God, that You would open up our hearts and our ears to receive this word. And Lord, most of all, that You would be glorified and honored in everything that we do. We love You, we praise You, and we thank You, Father. Have Your way, dear Lord, right now. Have Your way. In Jesus' name we do pray. And the church says amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Let's go ahead and sing a couple of them songs. What you got going on?
Thank you. have the monitors?
Oh, he's out right there.
He's scared.
Just go by faith, my sister.
In Church Hymnals, page 212, keep on the fire line.
Amen. Control over anything. I can tell you that as you watch the news, whether it be CNN or Fox News, and the news that comes across sometimes is a little scary. Sometimes when it comes across, you can hear the concern in the news broadcaster's voice that this is serious business. Now, I do know that in the past couple months, we've dealt with some pretty serious business as far as dealing with this COVID-19. And I'm telling you right now, there's an issue. People are concerned about the budget and worried about the money aspect of it. And I see that popping up as well. All the way around, people are concerned about what's next. There's one thing that I can tell you, is that Jesus Christ has full control over all things. There's nothing to be concerned about as far as your life, as long as you put your trust in Him. And as the Bible says in Proverbs chapter number 3, you trust Him with your whole heart. You lean not to your own understanding, and in all your ways you acknowledge Him. And the Bible says He will direct your path. You see, the problem is people start thinking about things on their own without the very counsel of God. They start trying to figure things out and saying, maybe if I do it this way, it's going to work out. And the problem is, if you go against the very grain of God's word, you'll find out that it will not work out. Because if you go with God, He already has it worked out. Can you say amen? I know the Bible says that all things work together for the good to them that love God and are called according to His purpose. I can tell you, as the Bible says, not all things are good. Sister Nancy, there's things that happen that aren't so good. They're even painful at times from the inside out. But I can tell you this to be true. As a child of God, you will know that all things work together for the good. And the end result will be this. Holding the never-changing hand of the Father, you will know that you will make it through the fiery trial. You'll make it through the test of faith. And you know the end result will be this. Your faith will come out as pure gold. Hallelujah. And knowing that whatever God has to put us through, I can tell you this, that He will get us through it. And Jesus Christ will be right there, not only with us as we go through it, but when we make it to the end, praise be to the Lord, He's there as well. I know, Sister Bridget, that God is already in the tomorrow. And I wonder if you can truly think about that. Will you understand this to be true, that God is already in the tomorrow? He's not held back by time. He's not held back by, you know, as we look at a 24-hour clock, He's not conformed to the very time that's there right now. But what God is beyond that. You see, He's eternal. And once our faith and our hope is put in Him, come what may, the end result will be that He is glorified and we'll be with Him for all of eternity. All we need to do is trust Him in that capacity. Praise be to the Lord. Brother Perez, He's never forsaken us. He's always been there. And I know Him as a personal Savior, but I also know Him as Lord. Praise be to God. And we have a privilege here this evening. We have Brother Orlando Perez and his family's here. And I know he's going to share with us a mighty word that's going to touch your heart. But also, I pray as it touches your heart, it goes with you forever. I pray as this word goes forth, that it would clear the way that the devil is trying to block some things in your life. I pray as this word goes forth, that it would clear the way so we can walk by faith and not by sight. I pray we'll be able to walk forward just knowing that God is still with us every step of the way, but knowing that come what may, if we have to go ahead and command that mountain to be moved, or He'll give us the strength to go over it, come what may, I know He will. Because everything with God is either yes or it's no. I'm glad at times it's been no. But I found out as long as you hold on to Him, oh, it's going to be yes, Lord, yes. Yes, Lord, yes. I praise you and I thank you. Hallelujah. So without further ado, I'm going to ask my brother to go ahead and come on up here and take your liberty and share your word. Amen. As God gives us the grace to do so, praise the Lord of glory. And take my own, my brother, take your time.
Amen, amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen, amen.
Gracias a Dios en esta noche.
Thank God this night.
En esta tarde noche.
In this afternoon.
Que podemos tonight, estar acá.
That we can be here.
Compartiendo la palabra de Dios.
Sharing the word of God.
En More Haven.
In More Haven.
Y con una familia ministerial maravillosa.
And with a great ministerial.
Y los algunos hermanos de la iglesia maravillosos.
And with some brothers in Christ.
Amen. Me acompaña mi amada esposa desde Venezuela.
From Venezuela, my wife accompanies me.
Y una tres princesas de Dios que han venido a estar con nosotros.
And three beautiful princesses that are the Amen. Word of God.
En esta tarde quiero compartir la palabra de Dios con ustedes.
In this afternoon, I want to share the word of God with you.
Hay un mensaje desde mi corazón que Dios me ha puesto que lo predique.
There's a message that has been placed in my heart from God to share with you.
Y el tema es el verdadero amor.
And the theme is the true love.
Amen.
El verdadero amor.
The true love.
Amen.
La primera parte nos dice lo siguiente.
The first part tells us the following.
Dios es amor.
God is love.
Y mostró su amor para con nosotros.
And he showed his love to us.
Primera de Juan 4:8.
First of John 4:8.
Nos dice lo siguiente.
Tells us the following.
El que no ama no ha conocido a Dios porque Dios es amor.
Sorry. Anyone who does not love does not know God because God is love.
Amén.
Amen.
Amen.
Oremos a Dios para que el Señor nos guíe en toda esta predicación.
Let's pray with our God.
Padre celestial, te adoramos y te bendecimos.
Heavenly Father, we are blessed to be here with you today.
Te damos gracias en esta tarde maravillosa.
We are very thankful for this afternoon.
Cuando vamos a predicar tu palabra.
Today we're going to preach your word.
Permite que esta palabra llegue a lo profundo de los corazones.
Help me to give this word to go to every heart.
Que alimente el alma.
To feed every soul.
De cada persona que le escuche.
Of every person that's hearing it.
En el nombre de Jesucristo.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Y para la gloria tuya, Padre.
And for your glory.
Amén.
Amen.
Amen. Praise
el verdadero amor.
The true love.
Como lo hemos leído, Dios es amor.
How we have read it, God is love.
Yes.
Y mostró su amor para con nosotros.
And he showed his love to us.
Primero de Juan 4:9 nos dice.
First of John 4:9 says.
En esto se mostró el amor de Dios para con nosotros, en que Dios envió a su Hijo unigénito al mundo para que vivamos por él.
In this the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him.
Entonces Dios mostró su amor al mundo.
So God showed his love to the world.
Como lo dice San Juan 3:16.
Like John 3:16 says.
Porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo que ha dado a su Hijo unigénito para que todo aquel que en él cree no se pierda, mas tenga vida eterna.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
Yes.
Ahora bien, ¿cuál es el significado del amor? ¿En qué consiste?
Now, you may question yourself, what is the definition of the perfect love? What does it consist in?
Primera de Juan 4:10 nos dice así.
First of John 4:10 says the following.
En esto consiste el amor, no en que nosotros hayamos amado a Dios, sino en que Él nos amó a nosotros y envió a su Hijo en propiciación por nuestros pecados.
And this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins.
La palabra propiciación significa cubrir.
The word propitiation means to cover.
Aplacar o cancelar.
to stop or to cancel.
Redimir con el pago de un rescate.
To redeem with the payment of a rescue. Amen.
Eso significa propiciación.
That is what propitiation means.
Y Romanos 5:8 nos dice.
And Romans 5:8 tells us.
Mas Dios muestra su amor para con nosotros, en que siendo aún pecadores, Cristo murió por nosotros.
But God showed his love for us in that while we are still sinners, Christ died for us.
Amen.
De tal manera que queda confirmado que Dios es amor.
Which is proven that God is love.
Y mostró su amor para con nosotros.
And that he showed his love with us, to
cuando
us.
Cuando envió a su hijo a morir en la cruz del Calvario.
When he sent his son to die in the cross for us.
Ahora bien,
now,
el primer mandamiento que debemos cumplir nosotros es amar a Dios sobre todas las cosas.
Now, the first commandment is that we should complete and love God over all of the things.
Amar a Dios es el primer mandamiento.
To love God is the first commandment.
Yes.
Ahora, ¿qué significa amar a Dios?
Now, what's the definition to love God?
Amar a Dios significa, primeramente,
to love God means
no hacer lo que a él no le agrada.
To not do what is not correct and right for him.
That's right.
Pero significa también,
but it also means
sí hacer aquello que sabemos que a él le agrada.
To do what he wants us to do. To do what he believes is correct.
Lo cual está revelado en su santa palabra.
Which is revealed in his holy word.
La Biblia establece qué es lo que a Dios no le agrada.
The Bible shares with us what is not what God loves.
Right.
En el decálogo de los 10 mandamientos de Éxodo capítulo 20.
In the 10 commandments in Exodus chapter 20.
Aparecen mandamientos como este.
Are shown various commandments, or 10 commandments like these.
No hurtarás.
You should not abort.
No adulterarás.
You should not sin.
No hablarás mal de tu prójimo.
Do not fornicate. Do not speak in bad about your partner.
No codiciarás la mujer de tu prójimo.
Do not want the wife of your partner.
Ni nada que pertenezca a tu prójimo.
Nothing that belongs to your partner.
No adorarás imágenes.
Do not worship any other images.
Allí está revelado las cosas que no debemos hacer porque a Dios no le agradan.
In the Holy Word, it's revealed what God does not want us to do.
Pero también hay mandamientos que tienen las cosas que a Dios le agradan.
But there are also commandments that God does want us to complete.
Right.
Como por ejemplo el mandamiento que dice así.
Like for example, the commandment that says this.
Honra a tu padre y a tu madre para que te vaya bien.
Listen and obey your father and your mother so that all of your life can be cherished.
Ese es el primer mandamiento con promesa.
That is the first commandment with promise.
Honra a tu padre y a tu madre para que te vaya bien.
Obey your mother and your father so that your life and corrections could be correct.
Y seas de larga vida sobre la tierra.
So that you can live a long eternal life in Christ.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Marcos capítulo 12.
Mark chapter 12.
Nos establece este primer mandamiento.
Establishes this first commandment.
Leemos así el versículo 28 al 30.
Mark 12:28-30 says the following.
Acercándose uno de los escribas que los había oído disputar, y sabía que les había respondido bien, le preguntó, ¿cuál es el primer mandamiento de todos? Jesús le respondió, el primer mandamiento de todos es, oye Israel, el Señor nuestro Dios, el Señor uno es, y amarás al Señor tu Dios con todo tu corazón, y con toda tu alma, y con toda tu mente, y con todas tus fuerzas. Este es el principal mandamiento.
Mark 12:28-30 says the following. And one of the scribes came up and heard them disputing with one another. And seeing that he answered them well, asked him, which commandment is the most important of all? Jesus answered, The most important is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. And you shall love the Lord with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the first commandment.
Ahora, ¿cómo demostramos el amor hacia Dios?
How do we demonstrate the love to our God?
En primer lugar, demostramos nuestro amor hacia Dios guardando su palabra.
In first place, we obey God by serving Him.
Lo dijo el salmista.
The psalmist said.
Salmo 119, versículo 9 al 11.
Psalms 119, verse 9 to 11.
Dice así.
Says the following.
¿Con qué limpiará el joven su camino? Con guardar tu palabra. Con todo mi corazón te he buscado. No me dejes desviarme de tus mandamientos. En mi corazón he guardado tus dichos para no pecar contra ti.
And Psalms 119:9-11 says, how can a young man keep his way pure? By guarding it according to the word. With my whole heart I seek you. Let me not wander from your commandments. I have stored up your word in my heart, that I might not sin against you.
Amen. ¿Qué significa guardar su palabra?
What does it mean to cherish his word?
Guardar su palabra, en primer lugar, es poner en práctica sus mandamientos.
To cherish his word means, first, to obey his commandments.
Segundo, cumplir sus estatutos y decretos.
Second is to follow the commandments.
Tercero, obedecer sus ordenanzas.
Third is to obey his word.
Cuarto,
fourth,
observar sus enseñanzas.
To observe his teachings.
Quinto, aplicar sus instrucciones.
To apply his teachings to our life.
Sexto,
sixth,
aceptar sus correcciones.
To accept his corrections.
Y séptimo,
and seven,
velar para no olvidar sus justos juicios.
Fast so that we don't forget his final judgments.
Eso significa guardar la palabra de Dios.
That's what it means to follow the word of God.
Ahora bien,
now,
también demostramos nuestro amor a Dios cuando somos sanos en la fe, en la doctrina.
We also show the love of God when we are pure in faith and in the doctrine.
Right.
Hoy en día se le está restando importancia a la doctrina.
Nowadays they have been jumping over the doctrine of the word of Christ.
Muchos engañadores desde los tiempos del apóstol Juan han salido por el mundo.
Many of the people back when John was giving his teachings have come to place nowadays.
Pero en este tiempo se han multiplicado.
But especially now they have multiplied.
Proclamando que la doctrina no es importante.
Saying that the doctrine is not important.
Pero hay pasajes a la luz de la Biblia.
But there's passages in the word of God.
El cual es el máximo intérprete.
Which is the most interpretation.
El máximo intérprete de la Biblia.
The most important interpretation of the Bible.
Es la Biblia misma.
Is the Bible itself.
La Biblia es su propio intérprete.
The Bible is its own interpretation.
Right, brother. Amen.
Tenemos pasajes como el de Gálatas 1, 6 a 12.
We have passages of Galatians 1, verse 6, 12.
Allí Pablo le habla a los Gálatas.
Here,
Pablo le habla a los Gálatas.
Pablo calls his disciples.
Y les dice, estoy maravillado de que tan pronto os hayáis alejado.
We are surprised that they have left them very quickly.
De aquel que los llamó por su gracia para seguir un evangelio diferente.
Of those who they have been called to go and follow his word.
No que haya otro.
Not that there's another one.
Sino que hay algunos que os perturban.
But that there's one that disturbs them.
Y quieren pervertir el evangelio de Cristo.
And they want to change the word of God.
Pero Pablo hace una advertencia.
But Pablo gives them a warning.
Dice, mas si aún nosotros.
He says, but if we ourselves.
o un ángel del cielo,
with the angel of God,
o anunciar evangelio diferente,
comes and tells us the word of God differently,
right, del que os hemos anunciado,
of the one that has already been given to us,
sea anatema.
You guys are a theme.
Como antes hemos dicho,
like how we've said previously.
También ahora lo repito.
Now today I repeat it.
Si alguno predica diferente evangelio,
if someone preaches a different word of God,
del que habéis recibido,
of the one that they have received,
sea anatema.
They are a thing.
De tal manera que ningún ser humano,
that's how any human,
ningún hombre, ninguna mujer,
no human, no woman, no man,
está autorizado,
is authorized,
para predicar un evangelio diferente,
to preach or teach a different word
del
of God,
que está revelado en la santa palabra,
other than the one that is revealed in the holy word of God.
Amen. That's right, brother.
Pablo le advierte a Timoteo.
Pablo warns Timothy.
En 1 de Timoteo 4, 1 al 6.
In 1 of Timothy chapter 4, verse 1 through 6.
Que dice, pero el Espíritu dice claramente.
But the Spirit tells us very specifically.
Que en los postreros tiempos.
That in the past times.
Algunos apostatarán de la fe.
Some people would go against the word of God.
Escuchando espíritus engañadores,
hearing spirits that tell lie,
y doctrina de demonio,
and doctrine of the devil.
Hoy en día,
nowadays,
hay muchas doctrinas de demonios,
there's a lot of doctrine of evil,
que se apartan de la verdad,
that they go away from the truth.
Hay muchos maestros,
there's a lot of pastors,
enseñando,
teaching,
conforme a sus propias concupiscencias,
showing what they believe, what they want to believe.
Come on,
y están haciendo que mucha gente apostate de la fe.
And they're making that a lot of people believe teachings differently than what the word of God says.
La apostasía en el cristianismo.
The truth about the Bible
hace referencia,
makes a reference,
al rechazo del cristianismo,
to the hatred that is against the word of God,
por parte de una persona anteriormente cristiana.
By a person that used to be a Christian, servant of the Lord.
Tiene que ver con engaños.
It has to be with lies.
Cristianos que encuentran herejías.
Christians that believe other stuff.
Y falsas enseñanzas.
And false teachings.
Difundidas por falsos maestros.
Taught to them by false pastors.
Y profetas.
And prophets.
Que amenazan con seducirlos fuera de su devoción pura a Cristo.
That they want to teach them a word that is not even in the Holy Word.
Pero Pedro nos advirtió también.
But Peter also warned us.
Segunda de Pedro 1, 19, 21.
Second of Peter chapter 1, verse 19, 20 through 21.
Pedro nos dice, tenemos la palabra profética más segura.
Peter tells us that we have the word of God more secure.
A la cual hacéis bien en estar atentos.
Than the one that we have to be very cautious with.
Como una antorcha que alumbra el lugar oscuro.
Like a torch that guides us in the darkness.
Hasta que el día esclarezca.
Until the day becomes light.
Y el lucero de la mañana salga en vuestros corazones.
And that the sun rises above us to our hearts.
Entendiendo primero esto.
Understanding this first.
Que ninguna profecía de la Escritura,
that no prophecy written in the word of God,
es de interpretación privada,
is of your private interpretation.
Porque nunca la profecía,
because the prophecy never,
fue traída por voluntad humana,
was brought by a volunteer,
sino que los santos hombres de Dios,
but the holy man of God,
hablaron siendo inspirados por el Espíritu Santo,
talked to us through this Bible, guided by Christ.
Esta palabra que está escrita,
these words, these teachings that are written in here,
es la palabra profética más segura.
Is the word that is mostly secured and more secured.
Hay que estar atentos a esta palabra.
We have to be attentive to this word of God.
Right. Así que mis amados hermanos que me escuchan.
Now, every one of you that hears me, brothers and sisters,
no tengamos miedo de las cosas que están pasando en el mundo.
Do not be afraid of what's going on in this world.
Porque todo lo que va a suceder,
because everything that's going to happen,
ya está revelado en la palabra.
It's already revelated in this book.
Leamos la palabra.
I love the word of God.
Escudriñemos la palabra.
Describe it.
Y tengamos confianza.
And believe.
En todo lo que está escrito en este bendito libro.
In everything that is written in this holy book.
Jesús dijo, el cielo y la tierra pasarán.
God said, the heavens and the earth will pass.
Pero mis palabras no pasarán.
But my words will not pass.
Amen.
Así que estemos atentos.
So be attentive.
A la palabra del Señor.
To the word of Christ.
A lo que ella dice.
To what it says.
A la doctrina revelada en la palabra.
To the doctrine that is revealed in this book.
Juan en su segunda epístola.
On 2 John chapter 9.
Versículo 9 al 11 nos dice.
Second John, verse 9-11.
Cualquiera que se extravía.
Anyone that goes away from him.
Y no persevera en la doctrina de Cristo.
And doesn't persevere in the doctrine of Christ.
Come on,
hay que perseverar en la doctrina de Cristo.
We have to persevere in the doctrine of Christ.
Y la doctrina de Cristo está revelada en su palabra.
And the doctrine of Christ is revealed in his book.
Juan dice, el que se extravía y no persevera en la doctrina de Cristo.
John says, the person who goes away and doesn't believe in the doctrine of Christ.
No tiene a Dios.
Does not have God.
Escucha lo que dice Juan.
Listen to what John says.
No tiene a Dios.
They don't have God.
El que persevera en la doctrina de Cristo.
The one that perseveres in the word of God.
Ese sí tiene el Padre y al Hijo.
They do have the Son.
Perseveremos en la doctrina de Cristo.
We have to persevere in the doctrine of Christ.
Para que tengamos al Padre y al Hijo.
So that we have the Father
y también
and the Son.
Al Espíritu Santo.
And that we also have the Holy Spirit.
Y Juan hace una advertencia muy fuerte.
And John gives you a warning very, very harsh.
Si alguno viene a vosotros.
If someone comes to us.
Y no trae esta doctrina.
And doesn't have this doctrine.
No lo recibáis en casa.
Do not receive him at your house.
Ni le digáis bienvenido.
Do not greet him.
Porque el que le dice bienvenido.
Because who gives him the welcome.
Participa en sus malas obras.
They participate in the wrong events that they do.
Juan dice, si alguno viene a vosotros.
John says, if someone comes to you.
Es decir, que siempre van a haber las amenazas.
There's always going to be threats.
Van a venir como le escribió Pablo en Hechos 20.
It's going to be like how in Acts chapter 12.
Lobos rapaces lo llamó Pablo.
There's going to be wolves that come to
lobos
you.
Lobos rapaces.
There's going to be wolves that come to you.
Hombres perversos.
Humans that are perverts. And
que arrastrarían tras sí a los discípulos. Arrastrarían tras sí a los discípulos.
They would go for you.
Right.
Juan dice, no lo recibáis en casa.
John says, do not receive him at home.
Recibirlo en casa puede ser escuchándolos online.
You can receive him by listening from a distance.
Por televisión.
Through television.
O recibirlos literalmente bajo tu techo.
Or receive them under your roof.
O montarlos en el altar de tu iglesia.
Do not bring them to the altar of your church.
Juan dice, no lo recibas en casa.
Do not receive him at home.
No importa que tengan mucha pompa.
It doesn't matter that they have this and that.
No importa que tengan mucho dinero.
It doesn't matter that they can bring you a whole bunch of offerings.
No importa que tengan mucho poder mediático.
It doesn't mean that they have a whole bunch of social media for you.
El Señor dice, no lo recibas en
God
casa.
Says, do not bring them into your home.
No le digas bienvenido.
Do not greet them in your home.
Ni a tu familia.
Not to your family.
Ni en tu iglesia.
Not to your church.
Guarda la sana doctrina.
Guard yourself, your family, and the word of God.
Porque así demostramos nuestro amor a Dios.
Because this is how we're going to show ourselves to God.
A Dios le agrada cuando guardamos la sana doctrina.
God loves when we guard his secured word.
La cual está revelada en su palabra.
Which is revealed in his word.
Hay que escudriñar la palabra.
We have to discover the word of God.
Para poder defender la sana doctrina.
To be able to defend the word of God.
Judas en su corta carta.
Judas in his short letter.
En el versículo 3 nos dice.
In chapter 3 it tells us. Verse 3.
Amados,
beloved ones,
por la gran solicitud que tenía de escribiros,
for the great solicitation that you had
acerca de nuestra común salvación,
near our salvation,
me ha sido necesario escribiros,
it has been good to receive,
exhortándoos,
to let them go,
que contendáis ardientemente,
so that we can understand,
por la fe que ha sido una vez dada a los santos,
for the word that has been given once to the saints.
Cuando Judas dice la fe que una vez ha sido dada a los santos,
when Judas says that the faith that has been given to the saints once,
esa fe a la que él se refiere es a la sana doctrina.
It's the faith that he's referring to, the guarded doctrine. Right.
La sana doctrina original.
The original doctrine.
Inspirada por el Espíritu Santo.
Inspired by the Holy Spirit.
Y él nos dice que contendáis ardientemente.
And he tells us to be happy.
Pero para contender ardientemente,
but to be able to be happy,
hay que conocer la doctrina.
We have to know the doctrine.
Hay que escudriñar la palabra.
We have to discover it.
Para poder defenderla.
To be able to defend it.
Aleluya.
Aleluya.
Él nos dice que contendamos.
He tells us to contain ourselves, to be happy.
En el versículo 4,
in verse 4 it says,
porque algunos hombres,
because some men,
han entrado encubiertamente,
have come in secretly.
Encubiertamente significa,
to come in secretly means,
se han disfrazado,
that they have disguised themselves,
de ministro de justicia,
like ministers of truth.
Se han disfrazado.
They have disguised themselves like ministers of God.
Usan el nombre de Jesús.
They use the word of God.
Hacen milagros.
They make miracles.
Para intimidar a las personas.
To intimidate the people.
Pero se han extraviado de la doctrina.
But they have gone far away from the doctrine of God.
Right. Tienen en poco el sacrificio de Cristo.
They have very low belief in the crucifixion of Christ.
Le colocan precio a sus milagros.
They put prices to their miracles.
Quieren que la gente pague por los milagros.
They want people to pay for the miracles.
Right. Pague por la liberación.
Pay for the liberation.
Dinero por los milagros.
They want money for the miracle.
Han estafado a mucha gente en el mundo.
They have taken a whole bunch of money away from people in the world.
Gente que no conoce la doctrina.
People that don't know the doctrine.
Quiero decirlo y que quede bien claro.
I want to say and to put it in public.
No podemos pagar nada por los milagros.
To have it very clear, we can't pay nothing for the miracles.
Ni por la liberación.
Not even for the liberation.
Ni por la salvación.
Nor for salvation.
Ni por ningún otro beneficio.
Or for any other benefit.
Porque ya Jesús lo pagó todo en la cruz.
Because Jesus already paid it all in the cross.
El sacrificio fue completo.
The crucifixion was everything.
Right. Su sacrificio fue perfecto.
His crucifixion was perfect.
Él dijo, consumado es.
He said, I am here.
Todo está pagado.
Everything is paid for.
La sangre de Cristo.
The blood of Christ.
Es lo único que necesitamos.
Is the only thing you need.
Para llegar al Padre.
To be able to get to the Father.
Para entrar al lugar santísimo.
To go into the holy place.
Y adorar a Dios todopoderoso.
And to serve God Almighty.
Y recibir sus milagros.
And to receive his miracles.
Recibir sus bendiciones.
To receive his blessings.
Recibir el perdón.
To receive his forgiveness.
Yes. Solo la sangre de Cristo.
Only the blood of Christ.
Pero estos hombres,
but these men,
han entrado encubiertamente.
Have come in disguise.
Come on, brother.
Los que de antes habían sido destinados, yeah, para esta condenación.
Because back then, in the times, they had already been said.
Right. Hombres impíos.
Men of darkness.
Que convierten en libertinaje.
That they bring the liberation.
La gracia de Dios.
The grace of God.
Y niegan a Dios.
And they
niegan a Dios.
They lie and they don't want to believe in God.
El único soberano.
The only one that is in heaven.
Y a nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
And our Father and our God.
Quien es bendito por los siglos de los siglos.
He is holy for the nations.
Aleluya.
Amen.
Aleluya.
That's right.
Gracias, Señor.
Hallelujah.
Gracias, Señor. Oh, Apocalipsis 1:3.
Apocalypse Revelation. Chapter 1, verse 3 says,
nos habla de la bienaventuranza.
Oh, it tells us about the blessings.
Yes. Nos dice bienaventurado el que lee.
Blessed is the one who sees.
Y los que oyen.
And the one who hear.
Las palabras de esta profecía.
The word of this prophecy.
Y guarda las cosas en ellas escritas.
And they cherish the things that are written in it.
Porque el tiempo está cerca.
Because the time is close.
Levante su mano allí donde está el tiempo está cerca.
Raise your hands and say the time is close.
Cada día que pasa.
Every day that passes.
Se acerca el tiempo de nuestra redención.
The time of us to be redeemed is near.
Se acerca el tiempo de ir a casa.
It's time. The time is getting close to go home.
Escuchen, mis amados hermanos.
Listen to me, brothers and sisters.
Nuestra ciudadanía está en el cielo.
Our citizenship is in heaven.
De donde esperamos a nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
Where we wait to see our Heavenly Father.
Él dijo, en la casa de mi padre muchas moradas hay.
He said that in the house of my Father there's a whole bunch of blessings.
Voy pues a preparar lugar para vosotros.
I'm going to prepare a place for you.
Y si me fuere a preparar el lugar.
And if I leave, I'm going to prepare a place.
Otra vez.
I will come again.
Y os tomaré a mí mismo.
And I will take all of you.
Para que donde yo estoy,
so that where I'm at now,
vosotros también
you will estén. Also be there with me.
Aleluya.
Hallelujah.
No perdamos nuestra perspectiva.
Do not lose your direction.
Todo esto es doctrina.
All of this is doctrine.
Al Señor le agrada que guardemos su palabra.
God wants us to cherish His word.
Demostramos nuestro amor hacia Dios cuando guardamos sus mandamientos.
Demonstrate your love to Him when you complete these commandments.
Jesús lo dijo en San Juan 15:10.
Jesus said it in John 15:10.
Jesús dijo, si guardareis mis mandamientos,
God said, if you cherish my commandments,
permaneceréis en mi amor.
You would stay in my love.
Así como yo he guardado los mandamientos de mi Padre.
Just like I have cherished the commandments of my Father.
Y permanezco en su amor.
And I stay in His love.
Permanecer en la doctrina de Dios.
To stay in the doctrine of Christ.
No es un capricho.
It's not it's not something you want to do.
Por lo tanto.
For all.
La manera objetiva.
Your main objection, objective
de demostrar nuestro amor hacia Dios,
to show our love to God,
es guardando sus mandamientos,
is to cherish His commandments,
los cuales no son gravosos,
the ones that are not repetitive,
cumpliendo sus leyes,
complying His rules,
sus estatutos,
His commandments,
sus decretos,
His teachings, right.
Más allá de la subjetividad,
more of that than what's already in place,
que podamos manifestar,
that we can manifest it.
Dios espera que toda nuestra manera de vivir,
God is waiting for us that our living style,
se vea que le amamos,
is for us to show that we love Him,
con todo nuestro corazón,
with all our hearts,
con toda nuestra alma,
with all our souls,
con toda nuestra mente,
with all our minds,
con toda nuestra fuerza,
with all our strength.
Amamos a Dios.
We love God.
Cuando guardamos su palabra.
When we cherish His word.
Cuando guardamos su doctrina.
When we guard His doctrine.
Este regalo que Él nos dejó.
This gift that He left for us.
Jesús se lo dijo a Satanás en su cara.
Jesus told the devil in His face.
No solo de pan vivirá el hombre.
Not only of bread will the human live.
Sino de toda palabra que sale de la boca de Dios.
But every word that comes out of the mouth of God.
Right, brother. Amen.
Entonces. Ya tenemos en claro lo siguiente.
So now we have clear what's next.
Dios es amor.
God is love.
Y mostró su amor.
And He showed His love.
Para con nosotros.
To us.
Y nos da el primer mandamiento.
And He gives us the first commandment.
Que es amarlo a Él.
That is to love Him.
Amar a Dios.
Love God.
Por encima de todas las cosas.
Over everything.
Con todo el corazón.
With all our hearts.
Con todo el alma.
With all our souls.
Con toda la mente.
With all our mind.
Y con toda la fuerza.
And with all our strength.
Amen.
Pero el segundo mandamiento.
But the third commandment.
Es amar al prójimo como nosotros mismos.
Is to love our partner like ourselves.
Y estamos hablando del verdadero amor.
We're talking about the real love.
Amar al prójimo como nosotros mismos.
To love our brother, our partner, like we love ourselves.
Mateo 22:39.
Matthew 22:39 says the following.
Dice, y el segundo mandamiento es semejante.
And the second part is the following.
Amarás a tu prójimo como a ti mismo.
You will love your partner, your brother, like you do yourself.
Amen.
Amar al prójimo es una deuda permanente.
To love your partner and brother is this.
En Romanos 13:8 nos dice.
In Romans 13:8 says.
No debáis a nadie nada.
Do not owe anything to anyone.
Sino el amaros unos a otros.
If not love each other.
Porque el que ama al prójimo.
Because the one who loves
a
brother.
Ha cumplido la ley.
Has complied with the law.
Esta es la única deuda que la pagamos.
This is the only debt that we have to pay.
Y automáticamente vuelve a nacer.
And automatically it comes and is reborn.
Es decir, perdonar, pagamos perdonando.
Is saying we pay by forgiving.
Y cuando nos damos la vuelta.
And when we give a turn.
Tenemos la deuda igual.
We have the same debt.
Right. Tenemos la deuda igual. Pedro se le acercó a Jesús.
Peter comes to God.
En Mateo 18, 21 y 22.
In Matthew 18, 21, 22. Chapter 18, 21 to 22.
Pedro le pregunta al Señor.
Peter asked God.
¿Cuántas veces perdonaré a mi hermano que peque contra mí?
How many times do I have to forgive my brother that has sinned against me?
¿Hasta siete?
Seven?
¿Siete?
Seven?
Jesús le dijo, no te digo hasta siete.
Jesus told him, I'm not telling you until seven.
Sino hasta 70 veces siete.
I'm telling you to multiply 70 by 70.
El que ama al prójimo ha cumplido la ley.
The one who loves a brother complies with the law.
Romanos 13, 9.
Romans chapter 13, verse 9 says.
Dice así.
Says the following.
Porque no adulterarás.
Because you will not fornicate.
No matarás.
You will not kill.
No hurtarás.
You will not abort.
No dirá falso testimonio.
You will not say false testimony.
No codiciarás.
You won't want other stuff.
Y cualquier otro mandamiento.
And any other commandment.
En esta sentencia se resume.
In this sentence, it's
amarás a tu prójimo.
You will love your brother.
Como a ti mismo.
Like yourself.
El amor no hace mal al prójimo.
The love doesn't harm your brother or you.
Así que el cumplimiento de la ley es el amor.
Now to comply with the law, it's to love one another.
Gálatas 5:14.
Galatians chapter 5 verse 14.
Porque toda la ley en esta sola palabra se cumple.
Because all the law in this word is complied.
Amarás a tu prójimo como a ti mismo.
You will love your brother like yourself.
Amar al prójimo.
To love your brother.
Es agradarle en lo que es bueno.
Is to do good in what's good for him.
Romanos 15.
Romans chapter 15.
1 al 3.
Verse 1 to 3.
Nos dice.
Tells us.
Así que,
now,
los que somos fuertes,
us that we are strong,
debemos soportar la flaqueza de los débiles.
We should support the weakness of the weak.
Right. Y no agradarnos a nosotros mismos.
And not to stuff for ourselves.
Cada uno de nosotros agrade a su prójimo en lo que es bueno.
Each and every one of us do well for our brother on what's good for us.
Para edificación.
For education.
Porque ni aun Cristo.
Because not even Christ.
Se agradó a sí mismo.
Did stuff for himself.
Así que amar al prójimo. Oh.
So to love your partner, to love your brother,
es agradarle lo que es
good.
Bueno.
Right. Amen.
Es agradarle lo que es bueno.
It's to do what's well.
Dice lo que somos fuertes.
It says the people that are strong.
Lo que somos fuertes espiritualmente.
The ones that are strong spiritually.
En unción.
In one.
Poder.
In power.
Ayuno.
In fasting.
Oración.
In prayers.
Intercesión.
And inner and prayers. Sorry.
Fuertes económicamente.
To be good in economy.
Físicamente.
Physically.
Ministerialmente.
Ministerially.
Profesionalmente.
Professionally.
Los que somos fuertes.
Us that we are strong.
Debemos soportar la flaqueza de los débiles.
We have to help the weakness.
Y agradarlos.
And help them in good.
En lo que es bueno.
In what's well.
Amar al prójimo es hablar verdad de él.
To love your partner is to say the truth in.
Y con él.
And with him.
Cuando amamos al prójimo.
When we love our brother,
solo decimos la verdad.
We only Ephesians chapter 4:25
nos dice así,
tells us the following.
Por lo cual, desechando la mentira.
By them that were saying lie.
Habla verdad cada uno con su prójimo.
Talk truth with your brother.
Porque somos miembros los unos de los otros.
Because we are members with one another.
Escúcheme, somos un cuerpo.
We are one body.
El cuerpo de Cristo.
We are the body of Christ.
El oído.
The ear.
Debe amar a la nariz.
Has to love the ear.
La mano debe amar a los pies.
Your arms have to love your feet.
Y los pies llevar al cuerpo a lugares buenos como este.
And your feet have to take you to good places like
donde
places
escuche
like this,
palabra de Dios.
Where you can hear the word of God.
Amen.
A Dios le agrada y ama.
God is thankful and is beloved.
Cuando pensamos bien del prójimo.
When you think good of your brother.
Zacarías 8:17 dice.
Zechariah chapter 8 verse 17.
Y ninguno de vosotros piense mal en su corazón contra su prójimo.
And none of us must think wrong of our brothers in our hearts.
Ni améis el juramento falso.
Do not love false judgment.
Porque todas estas cosas aborrezco,
because
dice Jehová.
All of these things I dislike.
Right. Así que amar al prójimo es pensar bien de él.
So to love your brother is to think good of him.
Amar a Dios y al prójimo es semejante y es lo máximo.
To love God and your brother is the most thing you can do.
Marcos 12:33 nos dice.
Mark chapter 12 verse 31-33.
Y amarle con todo el corazón.
And to love him with all your heart.
Con todo el entendimiento.
With all your understanding.
Con todo el alma.
With all your soul.
Y con toda la fuerza.
And with all your strength.
Y amar al prójimo.
To love your partner.
Como a uno mismo.
Like one yourself.
Es más que todos los holocaustos y sacrificios.
It's more than all the holocaust of the sacrifice.
Existen niveles de amor al prójimo.
There's levels to love your brother.
Primero, el amor de los esposos.
First, the love of your husband.
El prójimo más cerca de un esposo es la esposa.
The love more close that you have is of your wife or of your husband.
Y viceversa.
Or reversible.
El amor por los hijos.
The love to your kids.
El amor hacia los padres.
The love towards your father.
El amor a los parientes.
The love to your parents or your siblings or your family.
Aun cuando hay parientes que son difíciles.
Even when you have a rough family.
Que nos hacen la vida de cuadrito.
That they make your life in pieces.
Hay que amarlos.
You have to love
porque
them.
Hay que amar al prójimo.
Because you have to love your brother.
El amor a los vecinos.
You have to love your neighbors.
El amor a los enemigos.
You have to love all your enemies.
A los que nos ultrajan y calumnian.
The ones that say ugly stuff about us.
A los que nos aborrecen.
The ones that don't want us near.
El amor a los gobernantes.
The love to our government.
Y a todo lo que está en alimentación.
And to everything that you have.
El ingrediente que no puede faltar en nuestra vida.
The ingredient that you have to. Oh,
es el amor.
Is love.
Ese es el ingrediente que no puede faltar.
That's the ingredient that cannot miss.
Colosenses 3:14 lo dice. Colosenses 3:14.
Corinthians. Thank you, brother. Chapter 3, verse 14 says.
Y sobre todas estas cosas.
And over all these things.
Vestidos de amor.
Dress yourself in love.
Que es el vínculo perfecto.
That is the perfect thing.
Y por último, para concluir.
And for lastly, to conclude.
1 Corintios 13.
1 Corinthians.
Nos da las características. Nos da las características.
Gives us the characteristics.
Del verdadero amor.
Of the true love.
Y nos dice que el verdadero amor es sufrido.
And it tells us that the true love is hurt.
Es benigno.
It's it hurts us.
No tiene envidia.
It doesn't have envy.
No es jactancioso.
It's not something you want more and more.
No se envanece.
It's not something that perishes.
No hace nada indebido.
It's not something that does something that's wrong.
No busca lo suyo.
It doesn't look for its own thing.
No se irrita.
It doesn't go away.
No guarda rencor.
It doesn't have any hate.
No se goza de la injusticia.
It doesn't rejoice in what's not.
Mas se goza
justice,
de la verdad. Se
but
goza
it
de
rejoices
la verdad.
In the truth.
Todo lo sufre.
It all goes wrong.
Todo lo cree.
It all believes.
Todo lo espera.
It all waits.
Todo lo soporta.
It all takes in.
Y nunca deja de ser.
Never stops.
Porque Dios
because God
es
is
amor.
Love.
Que Dios nos bendiga en esta noche.
May God bless you tonight.
Oremos a Dios.
Let's pray to him.
Padre celestial, muchas gracias.
Heavenly Father, thank you very much.
Por tu santa palabra.
For your holy word.
Ayúdanos a mantenernos.
Help us to keep ourselves.
En el verdadero amor.
In the true love.
Amándote a ti sobre todas las cosas.
Loving you over all the things.
Y amando a nuestro prójimo como
and
nosotros.
Loving our brothers and sisters like
en
ourselves.
El nombre de Jesús
in
te lo pedimos.
Jesus, we plead.
Y te damos gracias.
And we give thanks.
Amén.
Amen.
Que Dios le bendiga.
May God bless you. And thank you very much.